Hello everyone, I'm teacher Valentina. Welcome back to our English classes. En el video de hoy vamos a repasar dos temas súper importantes que ya vimos en la unidad 6 de Learning Zone. Vamos a hablar de nationalities y seasons of the year with the months. Okay, so let's start. Alright, so our first topic is nationalities. Nationalities es la manera en que llamamos a alguien dependiendo del país donde nació o del país donde viene, ¿sí? Por ejemplo, I was born in Venezuela. I am from Venezuela, so I am Venezuelan. Now here we have Ariana Grande. She was born in the United States of America. She is from America, so she is American. Now here we have J Balvin. He is from Colombia. He was born in Colombia, so he is Colombian. And here we have BTS. They are from South Korea. They were born in South Korea, so they are Korean. Nationalities is very, very easy. You just have to know the country of the person and really find out how you say the nationality, because there is no rule for that. You just have to learn it. Alright, now the next topic we're going to talk about is seasons of the year. Seasons se refiere al cambio en el clima que podemos ver en nuestro ambiente durante las diferentes épocas del año, ¿sí? For example, in the northern hemisphere, el hemisferio norte, esta parte de arriba que tenemos en el mapa del mundo, there are 4 different seasons. The first one is spring, when flowers bloom and baby animals are born. It is during March, April, and May. Then we have summer, when it's super hot and there is no school, there is vacation. This is during the months of June, July, and August. Then we have autumn. It starts to get cold. You maybe will need a jacket. It is during the months of September, October, and November. We celebrate Halloween in autumn. And then we have winter, where it's super, super cold. You need jackets and jackets and jackets, and you need a hat, and you need clothes because it's super cold. And then you have snow coming from the sky. This is during the months of December, January, and February. Then, when we go to the southern hemisphere, esta parte de abajo del mapa mundi, sí, en el sur, es completamente opuesto. Son las mismas estaciones, es el mismo calor, el mismo frío y todo eso, pero en el opuesto. Es decir, cuando es spring en el norte, va a ser autumn en el sur. Cuando es winter en el norte, va a ser summer en el sur. Y así sucesivamente. Por ejemplo, in the northern hemisphere, during January, it's still winter. But in the south, it's summer. You can have a lot of snow and super, super cold weather in the United States in January, but in Argentina, in January, it's going to be super hot because Argentina is in the southern hemisphere, and since it's the opposite, in the south it will be summer. So that's everything for today. I hope you like this class, and thank you. Stay tuned for our next class.